Very good day to all of you. Here I am back again. In fact, I feel a lot of gratitude to those of you who regularly log in, listen, watch, and give your comments, your questions, your doubts. All these things actually enrich me. So that's why perhaps I selected this topic today. Let's understand. See, while the word gratitude is used very often, I want you to understand that there is a difference between gratitude and thanks. See, thanks is a very general concept or a gesture there. Anybody doing something to me, I have a sore throat and Arun brings me a glass of hot water, which I asked for, I immediately turn around and say thanks to him. I am entering into a public building. Somebody keeps the door open for me after he has passed by. He doesn't shut the door. So I go past that. I say thanks. Now, this thanks is a very, very commonly used word, which expresses that this little gesture or whatever you have done, I am good with it. We also use thanks in a very different way, if you have noticed. If somebody offers you a cup of tea and you don't want it, you say, no thanks. Oh, thank you, I don't drink tea, or something like that, isn't it? So this is how the word thanks is used, in a very general, simple way. Then, what is the difference between thanks and gratitude? Gratitude is for something which you have received, which you have acquired, or which you have. Sometimes gratitude can be to God for having given me life. Gratitude towards my parents because they brought me into this world. Gratitude can be because I got a good education. Now, a good education, whom do I owe gratitude to? That is where the question comes in. Gratitude could be to the fact that I was born physically fit and capable of going to school. Gratitude could be for my parents who paid my fees, took the trouble of getting me admission in a good school and brought me to the school. Gratitude can be to the teachers who very sincerely, patiently taught me and ensured that my knowledge or my, you know, learning has really been good. Gratitude can also be, for example, to the vehicle driver or the bus driver, you know, who brought me on a regular basis to school. Gratitude can be to my classmate in a subject in which I was really struggling and I was not doing well at all. This classmate of mine took the trouble of helping me, and therefore I managed to pass, I managed to do well, and I went on. But primarily, if you have noticed, gratitude is for something that I have acquired. And holding somebody responsible for what I have acquired makes me feel that gratitude. Let us also remember that gratitude is not inborn. You will come across so many people who, when something good happens to them, when somebody does a good gesture to them, they take it on the surface as a formality. They may say thanks, but they don't feel that gratitude. Take the example of an employer. My organization, my business, my establishment is running well because of my employees. They are the ones who are working hard day in and day out. And because of that, I am prospering. But do I feel that gratitude? Not always. Very often what I do is, I justify myself by saying, I'm paying him salary, isn't it? So it's his duty, he has to do it. Well, the question of my feeling gratitude towards him. But what I forget is that this person may have taken the salary, but not worked to the full efficiency, or may have even sabotaged the organization. When that happens, I immediately wake up and say, see, this fellow dished me, this fellow let me down, this fellow left me and went away. I'm very quick at criticizing. But the flip side, somebody who has been with me for years and years, it could be a domestic help, it could be a person working in your office, it could be the person who sweeps the roads in front of my house. My house is clean, my area is hygienic, the sanitation of my locality is pure because of that one person who comes diligently every morning and sweeps and removes the trash and the garbage. The other thing about gratitude that I want us to keep in mind is that gratitude should not be as an obligation, it should be a joy. When you feel obligated to somebody, that's not really gratitude, I feel. It is more like a duty that, okay, someone has done something to me. See, I'll take you now to the flip side of an organization. If I'm an employee in that organization, I feel obliged to be thankful to my employer. He pays me, and with that money, my household runs. So I feel thankful to him. But that, in a true sense, is not gratitude. It is just that I feel that because he is being nice to me, he is paying me, so I have a sense of obligation to feel thankful to him. But gratitude is something which comes deep down from within, where I celebrate what I have. And like I said, not everybody does that. It's not an inborn trait. We have to develop it. You heard of that proverb which says, the glass is half full or half empty. So you have a glass, and in that glass, you have the water or juice or whatever it is, up to the half level mark. There are people who look at it and say, it is half empty. I got only half the stuff, the other half is empty, and I don't feel nice about it. There are others who say, it is half full. So somebody has given me a glass with half the amount of liquid or the water, which is what Adil did just now to me by getting me this hot water. So when we realize that I have acquired something, I have achieved something, and very often it is something which we take for granted. You may have also heard of the proverb which says that I cried because I had no shoes till I met a man who had no feet. I am lamenting not having shoes because I have feet. So do I owe gratitude to the Creator that he gave me feet? Not everybody has feet. Some people do not have feet at all. So even if somebody were to present him with 10 pairs of footwear, what will he do with it? This is a subtle difference in the attitude which we need to acquire if we want to develop this thing called gratitude. And as I mentioned even in the topic, it enriches our life. Gratitude has very little to do with the other person. Gratitude is a lot to do with myself. Another simple example I'll give you, which I also practice. Whenever I find somebody who has failed in something, who has not been able to achieve success, and I am connected with him, or I'm observing him, or I'm close to him, so I get to know what he did, how much effort he put in, and finally what was the result. I am learning how to prevent failure by observing him and by analyzing him, right? So I don't make the same mistakes which he did, and therefore I am successful. Now, do I owe gratitude to that person? Yes, definitely I do. If he had succeeded and moved on, I would have never had that understanding of what makes failures. Because he failed and I could observe all his experiences. That is why I learned how to do it in a different way. And that is what should, you know, make us feel positive and have that gratitude. Now, when you develop this thing called gratitude, no, you start working more and more and more on it and develop the thing. Eventually, you know what happens? We start feeling that the world is a better place. We start liking people around us. Because when I acknowledge that I owe gratitude to my parents, I owe gratitude to the domestic servant, I owe gratitude to my best friends, I owe gratitude to my teachers, I owe gratitude to that neighbor of mine who gives me a lift whenever I need it. So what am I doing? I am expanding my field of gratitude. I feel thankful to more and more people. And that makes me feel that the world is a wonderful place and my life is going very well. I would also like you to go back to your childhood and visualize any teacher who was very strict with you. A teacher would immediately punish you if you did something wrong. A teacher would punish you if you didn't do your homework or if you didn't perform well in the tests. How angry we were with such a person. How we hated that teacher. But today, as a grown-up person, do you realize that you owe gratitude to that teacher? Because that teacher punished you, because that teacher was so strict with you, you performed better. And therefore, today you are in a much better situation than you would have been in if that teacher had not been so strict with you. Why I told you this is that very often we have a tendency of taking things for granted, what we already have, and complaining about what we don't have. Take the classic example of this wonderful city called Bengaluru. All the time I keep hearing people saying that there are traffic jams in Bangalore. You are stuck wherever you are going. It takes such a long time. You cannot predict how much time it will take for you to reach from point A to point B. It's so tiring and stressful to travel in this city. You're not wrong. Your complaint is valid. But do you realize the wonderful weather that this city has? Even when you are stuck in a traffic jam, do you realize a traffic jam in Bangalore city is a nice, cool place? A shorter traffic jam in some other very hot city would make you miserable. Even if you're stuck for a few minutes, the heat would make you miserable. Or in some cases, the cold would make you miserable. But here is a city which has traffic jams without excessive heat or excessive cold. So do I feel that sense of gratitude? That is what I am talking about. I would also recommend that you make a list of all the times or experiences or incidents when you went through a hard time. When you had setbacks, when there were hurdles, when there were failures. Most often we want to forget it, no? Okay, now it is over. Let me not keep going back to that bad days. I don't want to remember it. My suggestion to you is please remember and even put it on record, because when you remember the bad times, you learn to appreciate the good times. And you also understand that even though you went through a bad time, it is over now. Right now, you're not facing that hurdle or setback that you faced when you went through that thing. A simple thing, you know, all of you are aware that we have this, you know, service called Helping Hands. We have got 200, 300 volunteers, many of them from good walks of life, who desire to give of themselves by going to one of the hospitals, spending a few hours, just gently helping or guiding the patients. You know what I tell them? To be inspired, to keep being motivated to go back to the hospital on a weekly basis. Whenever you go, stop and think. There would be 500 beds in that hospital. So there would be 400, 500 people lying on those beds. They are unhappy people because they are sick. Sitting next to them, maybe 500 caretakers, their near and dear, their loved ones, the family members, who are forced to sit there because the patient is sick. They are unhappy people. There may be 500 people who come there into the outpatient department to get treatment and go back. They are sick, that's why they had to come to the hospital. They would have rather been anywhere else except in this hospital, but they have to leave everything else and come because they are not well. They are unhappy people. Even the staff, the doctors, have to come there as a duty. They have to clock in at the correct time. They have to see so many patients. They have to complete the work assigned to them. So they cannot be very happy people. But you, the volunteer who comes there and sits down and looks at all these people, you know that there is nothing pulling you down. You are not sick. Your family member is not sick. You're neither an inpatient nor an outpatient. So can you celebrate? And can you have a sense of gratitude that I am not sick? I am fit and fine, and I am watching all these people. The other thing that I wanted to tell you about gratitude is, please learn to express it. Look for the most unusual areas or points where you can express gratitude to someone. And that gratitude has to be more than just a passing thank you. It has to be from a deep sense of being, a sense of having blessings, having good things in life, and appreciating who was responsible for me getting it. I told you, it could be gratitude to God Almighty. It could be gratitude to your parents. It could be gratitude to a friend who did a small favor, but that helped you to move on and do very well in life. This is what I want you to do. So what I have done is that I have made a little thing called a gratitude journal. Okay, here it is, if you can see it clearly. In this little booklet of 8 pages, I have said, Team Banjara provides you with simple and practical ways to enrich your life by being thankful. Here is how you start each day with a grateful heart. So what is there in this thing? We have made it into slides, and Anis will just show it to you. Have a look. Yes, start each day with a grateful heart. Meaning to say, when you get up, tell yourself, see, I'm fit and fine. I've had a good night's sleep, or even a disturbed sleep, but I did manage to get a few hours of sleep. I may be having some aches and pains, but they are not so bad that I've suffered the whole night. If I don't have aches and pains, all the more reason to be happy and to be grateful for whatever it is. So make it a habit to start each day with a grateful heart. And then list out on a continuous basis what I inherited or received without any active efforts from my side. For example, I had to make no effort to be born to my parents. I had to make very little effort to live in my family home. So these things which I inherited or received without my active efforts, let me have gratitude for that. Then go back to childhood. Most of us have had a very happy childhood or a fairly happy childhood. Right? We take it for granted. Sometimes we even say, oh, I wish my childhood would come back. Childhood was so lovely, you know. Carefree days, playing around, doing whatever you wanted to do and things like that. We say all that, but do we identify and acknowledge why I had a happy childhood? Somebody was responsible for it. I could have been an orphan. I could have been living in an orphanage or a destitute home or living on the footpath. I didn't do that, no. I grew up in a home. I had all the basic things that I wanted. So can I make a list of all the good things that happened to me in childhood? That is what increases my gratitude. Then come to the present. My permanent supporters, pillars of strength, who are with me at all times, or most of the times, or at least when I need them, I know that they are there for me. They were there yesterday, last year, 10 years back, and they still continue to support me, still continue to be that pillars of strength, which allows me to move forward in life. Who are they? What are their gestures? What have they done for me? If I can keep on a continuous basis recording that, and as I told you earlier, expressing my gratitude for their being there for me and with me. Then comes my strengths. For example, if I have fairly good health, I'm not sick, do I express my gratitude for that? Yes, I may have kept good health by exercising, eating the right food, doing the right things, but that would not have been enough unless my other pillars of support ensured that I keep good health. For example, I go back again to the same thing. In my childhood, if my parents gave me good nutritious food that strengthened my body to an extent so that today, even if some infection comes, I can withstand it. So I owe gratitude to them. I may even have had a cook in my house who used to cook food for me lovingly. And that ensured that my nutrition was good. I may have a doctor who takes care of me whenever I fall sick and immediately ensures that I come back to normalcy. Yes, whenever I have a need, I go, I get the cure from the doctor, I pay the fees and I come back. But that doctor also is deserving of my gratitude, isn't it? So like this, explore and see how many things we deserve to be gratitudes of. So what I suggest is, take any notebook, or if you are more of the tech type, take your phone notepad and record on a daily basis any small blessing received by writing down the date and writing down the event. This is what happened on such and such date. If we don't do that, we forget. And when we forget, we don't have that feeling of gratitude to whoever was responsible for those good days that, or those blessings that I received. So in a nutshell, this is what, you know, I thought I will tell you. The same thing I have put down in this gratitude diary, what I inherited, you know, from my in my childhood and from my elders and whatever it is. Then my permanent supporters, as I told you just now, my, you know, strengths that keep me going. All these things, if you can do that, that's the reason why we have this gratitude journal. If anyone of you is interested in having a few copies, which you can also distribute among your friends or relatives, you can tell Venu, he will give you these copies if you want. But the idea why I made this is so that something remains in your hand which keeps reminding you. Otherwise, we have a tendency to forget, get too busy with our daily life. And also remember that when we, you know, take things for granted, when we do not have that gratitude in our heart, when we lose something, that is when we suddenly become aware. I may have a grandfather who's wonderful to me, who, you know, nurtures me in so many ways, but I take him for granted. The day he passes off, that is when I realize what have I lost. So if I have this sense of gratitude, I keep imbibing from him, and his legacy lives on even if he is no more. So like I told you, start the day with some very, very positive thoughts, which are of gratitude that, you know, I have these blessings, I have these gifts, I have these wonderful things in my life, and let me now begin the day with that. I also want to exhort you to end the day on the same note. Whatever good and bad may have happened, when you are ready for bed and have finished every other aspect of your daily routine, please stop and think, what did I receive today for which I should have gratitude? And if you make it a habit, let me tell you, you will slowly find things. Even on a day which has been very bad, you had a major setback, you had some crisis on that day, if you develop this feeling of gratitude, you know what happens is, out of all these horrible and bad things that happen, there is always that little ray of sunshine. And you say, yeah, the day was horrible, but this one thing that happened to me, maybe even unexpectedly, that made my day brighter. And for that, I feel a sense of, you know, gratitude. It takes time, it takes a little bit of effort and a lot of consistency. But mark my words, if you keep doing these little simple exercises on a regular basis, one odd day, even if you miss out, it doesn't matter. Make sure that you catch up at the earliest. And the next day, you should not miss out. Keep doing that. Adding to that, the last point that I wanted to tell you was, be in the company of positive people, or people who have a sense of gratitude, people who are optimistic, people who enjoy life and look at the positive aspects of their life. The more you are in that company, the more you will feel that life is wonderful and I have this thing. And when you acquire a group of such people around you, don't forget to express your gratitude for them to be there and to inculcate that same feeling of thankfulness in you. Keep that in mind. Give me a minute. Sonal is here to update you on what's happening, and then we'll continue.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, Anita, Haider, Madhu, Debashri, Shobha. So many of you from different places, different cities, I would say, different towns. Roshan is here from Hyderabad. There are so many people who joined on every Saturday to listen to Ali, who is our, I would say, permanent supporter. And definitely many of us carry a lot of gratitude towards him and towards Banjara Academy. Like today morning, we had gone, Jayanti, me and Nagveni, we had gone to one of the organization for parents workshop. And these parents were of, their children are between 6 and 8 years old. We can understand today's generation being so naughty, notorious, to take care of them is not easy. At the same time, when in the morning, when we got to make them do some gratitude exercises, they were like, oh my God, in today's world where people are telling I don't want children and they are bringing animals into their life, nothing wrong in that. We have children. Are we thankful to God for that? That was a wonderful gesture and wonderful awakening, I must say. Right? So, to give you update on what's happening at the academy, Diploma in Counseling Skills has started in full swing. And you all know how much our students enjoy doing that. If somebody is not in Bangalore and is willing to join hands to do this good work, to be in somebody's life, to be a permanent supporter, I think you can think of IPCG, which is International Program in Counseling and Guidance. Whoever is outside Bangalore can approach the academy. Anise will just put the office numbers on the chat box and join the club to become a counselor. Do good to people around you, be their permanent supporters, be there in their journey of gratitude, and feel good about yourself that you used your life in a very nice way or a good deed. Or I would say, when you sleep in the night, as Ali was telling, that do you feel gratitude about what all has happened through the day? I would say, think of the fag end of your life also. When you are in those stages, when you think that, you know, I'm going to leave this world, or, you know, whenever, at any stage, what have I done? What have I contributed to this world? I think counseling is such a noble thing to do so. And IPCG, International Program in Counseling and Guidance, there are students from overseas also. So if you have relatives who are interested to be in someone's journey of gratitude, please connect them to Banjara. We are here for you, for everyone in this journey to help many more.
Yes, I'm back, and I can see that there are a lot of comments already in the chat box. So let us see what all good ideas you have given to us. We shall start with Madhu. Madhu says, yes, it's true. I have been through this. It was a very, very scary time, but then it passed away, thank God. See, this little thing of thank God, because if God wanted, our punishment and our bad times could have continued, no? So there's somebody sitting up there, some creation, some great source of energy, some guru, whatever you want to call. But do I realize that there is somebody who influences my life, who brings me out of these things. It could be my own relative or best friend. It could be God Almighty. It could be your guru. It could be your scriptures. It could be just about anything. But the important thing is that do I feel that gratitude? Okay. Roshan says, when one is grateful, that emotion will multiply and find more around to fulfill us on a mind, body, and soul level. Gratitude is just one emotion that allows us to connect to higher intelligence. Without gratitude, we could have everything on a material level and still be unfulfilled. Yes, that's why we are miserable when we don't develop that sense of gratitude, no? Always one has to count their blessings. All too often, we do not realize how much something meant to us until it's gone. That's what I had also said, you remember? From my experience, we are bound to be successful if we are grateful for all the things that we have. Yes. Anita says, good afternoon. Good afternoon to you also, Anita, and to all of you. Yes, Srikanteshwara says, yes, we are happy to express gratitude to Ali and all. Thank you very much. And I really appreciate whenever somebody genuinely expresses some form of gratitude for the little work that I'm doing. Surekha says, when we are grateful, we are humble. Very important, very relevant point. Please make a note of this. That's why gratitude and ego cannot coexist. They are mutually exclusive. People with a very high ego think that they have gained everything. They have achieved everything. They are responsible for their success, their wealth, their good looks, their everything they feel. But those who have gratitude as part of their being, they automatically become humble. Because gratitude teaches us that we have received so many blessings without having to make effort for it. Surekha also says, for many years, I resented my mother's very strict disciplinary ways. Today, looking back, I am flooded with gratitude for how ceaselessly she encouraged us to maintain a loyalty around a value system. In fact, that's the main thing that has helped me weather the storms of my life. The same thing I had mentioned about teachers who are very strict. And here Surekha gives us a very good example of a parent who we as children may have felt that my parent was very, very strict, was being very rigid, was, you know, putting me on through a lot of challenges. But today we know what we have gained because of our having such a parent. Surekha also says, you cannot be grateful and unhappy at the same time. Exactly, that's what I, right in the beginning I mentioned that gratitude should be in a sense of joy and not a sense of obligation. It's emotionally impossible to feel both. The moment you start feeling grateful, your unhappiness, your sadness, your lower, you know, feelings, they automatically start moving away. You start feeling that the world is a good place. Things are happening, positive things. Madhu says, yes. We all have gratitude towards Ali. Oh my God, please, that's not what I wanted. Anyway, thank you very much. I learned how to live and do my responsibility with grace. Always thank you. Yes, Madhu. And I thank you for this sentiment, for feeling this way. You could have forgotten and moved on over the years, but you still remember and you still express it, which makes me develop a strong sense of gratitude, not only to Madhu, but all of you. Anita says, I'm grateful to you for giving me life purpose. Hey, this is now becoming a gratitude to Ali, please. I want to hear more beyond Ali, right? Yes, Haider says, through Banjara, I learned how to live authentically. That's a very good word. I really appreciate that. Living authentically, a real, meaningful, purposeful life. I am always grateful to Dr. Ali and team Banjara for that. Please make a note that we should aim for having an authentic, a genuine, and a fulfilling life, not a happy life. Pushpa says, thank you, Ali, because of BCS, whole life has changed. And this is Pushpa saying this almost 20 years after she did DCS. And she is a highly qualified doctor. So you know how much she experiences life when she feels that way. I think I feel humbled and all of us feel humbled. Madhu also says, gratitude made me feel contented and happy. Also, I am radiating around me. This is a wonderful thing, you know. When you get that feeling of fulfillment, a sense of enrichment, you automatically start radiating into the others. It's a ripple effect. There are other people who start feeling better because of you. Remember that. Vinita says, sometimes I feel being gratitude also helps us to stay grounded and on the right path. Very true, Vinita. And once again, thanks to you, Ali and Bandara, for showing us the new path by reaching out to so many of them. It's a wonderful feeling I get every day. This is what I've been telling all of you. This should be there every day, not to Ali or Bandara, whatever it is, but to every source of your joy, your fulfillment, your, you know, achievements, your purpose in life. It should be something which encompasses you, which becomes part of life. Surekha says, when my daughter expresses gratitude when I cook something special for her, it makes me feel good about myself and I am more inclined to do something else for her. Now I want all of you to note this down. When you have a sense of genuine gratitude, most daughters would say, it is mother's duty to cook. No, she is the homemaker. She has to cook for her children and they can take her for granted. But here is a daughter, and I'm sure part of her gratitude at least is because of the upbringing that Surekha has given to her daughter. So when the daughter expresses that gratitude, as Surekha said just now, it inspires and motivates Surekha to do better. So who is the beneficiary? The beneficiary is her daughter. So this is how, as I was saying, when you have gratitude, your life gets enriched. Surekha also says, when my fellow fourth standard students had labeled me as the drawing Dumbo, my teacher fiercely looked into my eyes and said, you cannot let somebody else's opinion become your reality. I am grateful for this esteem building experience because she taught me to honor and believe in myself, even if the world didn't. That is what happens. That's why towards the end of the first half, I said, no, be in the company of positive people, not only teachers, friends, neighbors, anybody. Look for people who are positive, who have gratitude in their minds. You automatically will find that that rubs off on you. Madhu says, even for my husband and mother-in-law, who have made my life so lonely and bitter, I have respect and gratitude. Amazing, Madhu, I really hats off to you. Because of them, I became a strong lady and able to bring up my children and be a role model to them. See, this is what happens. Sometimes people who are bad to us, people who are insensitive to us, or people who put us down are actually doing us a favor. And when, because of them, we decide to struggle it out, we decide to overcome hurdles, we decide to prove ourselves, when we do that, actually we owe gratitude to these people because they are the one who inspired us to move on and achieve, isn't it? Sahana says, gratitude to you and Manjara for offering DCS to people of all walks of life, which has changed my quality of life, and I'm sure for everyone who walked this path. Thank you very much, Sana. Ashwini Ash says, I am grateful to God for sending good people, especially my friends and my supporters and well-wishers. There are two aspects to what Ash said just now. I am grateful to those people who are my supporters and who are, you know, nice to me, my friends, etc. And I will spend more time with them. At the same time, she said, I am grateful to God for sending such people to me. See how when you look for ways and means to develop that feeling of gratitude, it grows and grows and grows. Right, Srekha says, when we take somebody for granted, are we not being ungrateful and unappreciative of their efforts? Very much. And by doing that, we either develop an ego saying that I did everything by myself, or in the minimum, we don't have that sense of joy and fulfillment that I'm surrounded by good people. They give me so many things. Because of that, them I am benefiting so much. We are depriving ourselves of that by having that attitude. Vinita says, yes, very truly, when my kids say thank you, when I make their special dishes on special occasions, it feels so good. And you know, these thanks and this and that can come from the most unexpected sources. Just keep doing whatever best you can, and you will find that even if there are one or two people who do not express their gratitude, one is, you know, sometimes people who feel gratitude unfortunately do not express it. They say, no, what is there? She's my mother, she's my friend. So they don't feel comfortable expressing it. And that should be a lesson to all of us, that when we feel gratitude to whoever it may be, we should express it. Maybe not to people who have been nasty to us and because of that we learned a lesson and all that. I can keep that gratitude in my heart and say, no, I don't want to have anything to do with them, but I have this sense of gratitude. But all other people, I would request you to please make sure that you keep expressing your gratitude in as imaginative and as diverse ways as you can. Madhu says, I had a tough time with my helpers by showing my gratitude to them. I would say thank you or buy gifts or give sometimes to the money. They took me for granted and my work not done. So I had become firm too. I wanted to quickly share an incident. I met a niece of mine after a very, very long time, and her father-in-law was telling me that I, you know, started an industry long back, a small industry, which employs workers who are basically illiterate people. And they worked. That generation was different. 20, 30 years later, the next generation came in. And the young workers did not have the same sentiment as their elders or their parents had. And we started having labor problem. So he said, what I started doing was, on every occasion, I would go to the house of these people and meet up with their parents who are retired, who are elderly, and convey my gratitude that you worked in my factory for 30 years. Because of that, we are prospering. You may have retired and gone home, but I have not forgotten you. He says the ripple effect is that they tell their children that you must be loyal to your employer. You should be good to them. And because of that, I have no labor problem now in my factory, even with these young employees. See the benefits of having that gratitude, right? Okay, Kishan says, I do show gratitude by saying thank you politely. And for example, if I take an auto and if I feel I have a good experience, I pay a little extra on my own. However, sometimes I wonder if just polite thank you is enough to people when you feel you may not meet them again, for example, doctors. Yes, Kishan, not only doctors, even that auto rickshaw person. You know, the way to express the gratitude is that you say thank you. At the same time, supposing it's a hot day, and this auto rickshaw driver has been plying his auto in the hot weather. If you can add to your thank you a genuine positive stroke of saying that I just came in your auto for 15 minutes and I'm dropping off and I'm going under the shade of my home and under the fan. But you are spending the whole afternoon out in the hot sun, and you are still, you know, being nice. You are driving the auto properly. You are being polite to me. And that is why I feel that you are a great person. That is what helps. Srikanteshwara says, immaturity, ego, etc. cover gratitude feeling. Yes, we have already discussed ego as being, you know, against gratitude. Immaturity also. People who are immature, who are self-centered, who don't realize the value of the blessings or gifts that they have been receiving, right from the creation down to their parents, to friends, to whoever it may be. So we should learn to grow up and feel greater gratitude. Ashwini also says, my husband, I know he is grateful to me, but never expresses. But his few actions convey it is men, because of ego, don't express it. It is a fact, Ashwini. Boys are brought up not to be sentimental and not to be emotional. So when he grows up and he has a life partner and he appreciates his life partner, he knows her value, he knows all that she is doing for him, he finds it very difficult to say it verbally. But even if he does it non-verbally, it is wonderful. Going back to the example of the auto rickshaw driver, if I have some eatable, a packet of biscuits with me, when I'm getting down, if I can say that, I don't know when you'll have your meal or something, so I have this extra packet of biscuits, I thought I'll share it with you, eat it whenever possible. That gesture has far more effect than just a simple thank you. Because that person understands the depth of what you felt, that I am driving this auto in the hot sun. I may not even be having my meal on time. This person felt what I'm going through and has also appreciated the fact that I drive safely, I brought him on time, I didn't demand more money, and that is why he's giving me this packet of biscuits. Okay, Madhavi says, hi, thank you, Ali, and my Bandara friends. Each one I meet, new learning for me. Yes, thank you to Almighty. He tested me, gave good things at the end, so I always feel everything happens for good. Yes, true. Yes, and we are coming to the end of the hour. Madhu says, because of my experience of gratitude, I am able to build a bridge between my relationship with my close relatives. And now I have a winner smile. That's wonderful. People even who shower smiles at others, even that is a way of expressing gratitude. So I will end the session with my smile to all of you, my gratitude to all of you, and with the message that Anis is giving you about next week. The topic is problem solving and decision making. It is not next week because next Saturday happens to be a major festival, Ganesha festival. So I was told most people would be busy. So we'll take a gap on 7th of September. Because of the Ganesha festival, we will skip this every live. The next session will be on 14th of September, Saturday, as usual, 2 o'clock, which is problem solving and decision making. The other next 2 weeks topics also Anis has put on to you so that you can understand what are the forthcoming topics. So sometimes, you know, when you have a topic in future which is specifically useful to you, you may feel like, you know, making a note of it and attending that. So thank you and have a wonderful day.